Hello, in this lesson, we are going to continue developing our components. In the previous lesson, we created these components here in the bottom. That's a button with icon components. So we can easily replicate it, insert a new icon and a new text. And now we want to add actions to this because I just inserted the components here in my app and I cannot find the onSelect property. Since it's a component, it doesn't have these properties as a button in powerapps has, and we need to add. If we look at the components, let's go back to components, that's where we created it. Here we have the image and the text, and there is no way to create a custom property called function, but there is a way, and we need to enable it in the app configuration. If I go to settings, then I have here upcoming features, and possibly in the experimental area we have, let me find, enhanced component properties. This is experimental, it means it's not ready for production, but it has been here for more than a year. Possibly it will become a production thing and you can experience that to learn how to build, and in the future when it becomes available you can use. Okay, so if you click on check to on, then once I go back to components, here on my component, if I click on new custom property, then we should have different properties here. Here, property type, we have other types, function, event, and action. Each one of them is used for one purpose, but in this case, I'm going to select the event. This type of property allows you to create an event that the component can trigger and then be handled by the app. Let's see. So I'm going to select event. Okay, now this onSelect appears here in the custom properties as an input together with inText and inButtonImage. If we go back to the app, for example, click on this one, home, we don't see it here because it's an action type, but event type. But here in this dropdown, we see the onSelect here. And here we can pass whatever function, whatever formula we want as if it was a button. So let's say, for example, in this case, it's going to be navigate to home screen. Okay. Navigate to home screen, close the parentheses. And then this call, this function is passed to the onSelect. Well, if I just select, if I click, nothing is going to happen because I need to tell inside the component on which element that I'm click, I'm going to call this onSelect. So if I go back to the component, for example, I could select the image, and in the onSelect of the image, then I could call the com icon dot onSelect, and then I will be getting the formula in the input of the component and passing to the onSelect of the image. Now, when I click in the image, it will call whatever I put in the onSelect of the component. Right, but what if the user clicks in the text? We also want to navigate or do the action we want to do. I'm going to put the same formula in the onSelect of the text. Later, we are going to make it better. We are going to do it differently because we don't want to add to all the elements in the screen the same formulas, all the elements in the component, I mean. So in the onSelect of the text, let's also put the formula comIcon.onSelect, getting the formula that's passed to the component. Now let's go back to the screen, hit play, and see what's going to happen. If I click here, it navigates back to the home screen because it calls the onSelect that I passed as the input. And in the input, I had that formula that's navigate. Going back to find contacts, let's do the edit now. We have the old button here with the formula that calls the edit form and navigate that we saw in the previous lessons. Let's put this in the onSelect of this component now. So in the onSelect, I'm going to paste it, and let's see. So I will select one contact, and then click in the edit that will call the formula and make able to edit that context. Very good. So now I can get rid of this icon here because I don't need it anymore. Very good. Let's complete this lesson by just doing some small adjustments. For example, here they are not spaced correctly. Let's add a horizontal container to make this automatic for us. So I'm going to go to Insert. Let me search horizontal container. And then just put it here. I'll select all the controls here, all the components, Control X to cut, and then I'm going to paste inside the container. With the container selected, we can align to the center and space evenly. Let's put a margin in the left, let's say 32 and 32 in the right. Okay, now everything is evenly spaced without much effort. Let's rename the container. In this case, I'm going to call con action buttons, and we could also rename the buttons. This one is com icon. I will call com icon home. The second one, com icon WhatsApp. The third one, com icon phone. And the last one, com icon edit. We also have this container in the top, that's the filter. So filter container, I'll call con filter contacts. Just to make everything named accordingly. Very nice. In the next lesson, we are going to see how we can make a hover effect here, because right now it doesn't indicate that we are hovering it, doesn't show any difference, doesn't show that's clickable. So we are going to see how to do that and also improve that thing I mentioned, that we put the formulas in the icon and in the label and we want to put in one single place. So we are going to see that in the next class. See you there.